The young lady flatters me. It was not love at first sight. For either of us. There was attraction, certainly. At least on my part. But Miss Bridgerton thought me presumptuous, arrogant, insincere. All fair, really. And I thought her a prim young lady barely out of leading strings. Not to mention the sister of my best friend, and so romance was entirely out of the question for both of us. But in so removing it, we found something far greater. We found friendship. You see, Miss Bridgerton and I have been fooling all of Mayfair for quite some time. We have fooled them into thinking we are courting. And really, all along, we simply enjoyed each other's company so much we could not stay away from one another.
When the days are cold and the cards all fold and the saints we see are all made of gold. When your dreams all fail and the ones we hail are the worst of all and the bloods run stale. I wanna hide the truth, I wanna shelter you. But with the beasts inside, there's nowhere we can hide. No matter what we breed, we still are made of greed. This is my kingdom come, this is my kingdom come.
Oh, I am flattered, I'm afraid I must reject your proposal.
Yes, I know. I'm not the marrying type.
My eyes, it's where my demons hide. It's where my demons hide. Don't get too close.
Why do you think I followed you into that garden?
Why do you think I went into that garden?
Gardens call, it's the last of all. When the lights fade out, all the sinners crawl. So they dug your grave and the masquerade will come calling out at the mess you've made. Don't wanna let you down, but I am hellbound, though this is all for you. Don't wanna hide the truth. No matter what we breed, we still are made of.
I am so sorry.
What? Even a duke cannot control the weather.
I know that this is not what you had envisioned for the evening.
Certainly not.
For that,
it is better. I know why you made that vow to your father. I found the letters you wrote to him as a child, and I read them.
Yes, ma'am.
Just because something is not perfect does not make it any less worthy of love. Your father made you believe otherwise. Every flaw, every imperfection. I love you.
I've never been a man that much enjoyed flirting, or chatting, or indeed talking at all with Daphne. Miss Bridgerton. Conversation has always been easy. Her laughter brings me joy. To meet a beautiful woman is one thing, but to meet your best friend and the most beautiful of women is something entirely apart. And it is with my sincerest apologies, I must say, it took the prince coming along for me to realize I did not want Miss Bridgerton to only be my friend, I wanted her to be my wife. I want her to be my wife. And so I plead with you not to make us wait.
Look into my eyes, it's where my